done with sports talk worldwide with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Yeah, I'm laughing. You know what I'm saying? I'm laughing. Because, you know, it's been about 3 weeks since Dillian White and Oscar Rivas fought. What about July the 20th? All right? You know what I'm saying? That's what's happening. And that B sample, or that positive dope test with all the metabolites in the system, that B sample still ain't coming through, you know? You know what they up to? They up to the old, you know, don't say nothing for a while trick, right? You know, because it works on bigger things than a dope test. You know what I'm saying? Let's make sure this is clear. Golden Boy Promotions is one of the biggest promotions. Oscar De La Hoya and them, right? Ring Magazine, they call that the Boxing Bible. We have them on emails calling Al Heyman, who now everybody knows, just don't have to see him. That's why you don't see him. Call them niggers in the emails and the Black Hitler and all that. And a whole bunch of other little stuff, right? And what they did, the old, we just won't say nothing for a while. We won't rebuke it. We just won't say nothing. And it'll go away because brothers are like that. Most of us. I am remembering that and mentioned it. That's why it won't be no pound for pound list from Ring Magazine. And I really don't give a damn what Oscar De La Hoya does or says until he renounces that. Don't really like ESPN anymore because he's been on First Take and other programs several times after that and was never, ever asked. And these are people who got the inside scoop. Kidding me? They told, don't ask that. Right? Let it go away. So that's why it's going away. So the thing is, people can try the old don't say nothing for a while trick. You know what I'm saying? And we're going to just forget the metabolites that Dillian White got popping off. Metabolites. Okay? No. We're not forgetting. It's 3 weeks out. Whatever. But what is the B sample? Should have been coming back a long time ago. You know what they kept holding the B sample for? Holding the B sample for this. What can we tell these people? That's what they're going around. First of all, let's give it Oscar Rivas' camp, right? And we're going to have to get an out-of-court settlement, right? Something going down with them because Oscar Rivas and them about to sue somebody, rightfully so, about the gloves and not telling them prior to the fight. So they're probably negotiating with them and figuring out these governing bodies, not governing bodies, but the doping agencies in accordance with promoters or whatever are figuring out what can we do. Because actually, it's an open-shut case. Basically, what's up with the B sample? Let's find out and let's keep on moving. Ain't got to be like that. Dillian White is kind of a high-profile fighter. It's not that many. I told you, it's one of the big ones. You don't want to just take them out of the sport, you know? So they probably figuring out they're finagling. That's what I think, because it's basically open and shut. Now, everybody's, you know, you're hearing the rumors of, hey, you know, we got to wait until Dillian, you know, just like everybody else. They're innocent until proven guilty, right? I mean, everybody doesn't get treated that way. You know, let's be real. Don't let me start talking about Central Park 5. Nothing like that. I'm just saying everybody's not. People, a lot of types of people are guilty first. Right? But we ain't going there. It should be. You're innocent until proven guilty. Right? So, you know, basically, you know, but you got a test was tested and it had not a little bit of stuff. So it's a whole lot of accidents that happened. These metabolites and the hydro, remember hydro and epic? Lepidolamine or whatever it's called, right? And then with none at the end of the words, them some heavy duty stuff. Diabols, right? Whatever that stuff is called, that's that drug. Once you know, hearing about it, you're getting more and more educated about it, right? One of the first steroids, right? Make it real strong, whatever. Even Deontay Wilder been talking about it. That's some heavy duty stuff you got in your system, right? So, and I've also heard the things in the other direction where, hey, you know what? He had Vada testing either before or after, or even both, right? And it was, you know, nothing in there. So that's going to help him in his case, right? That would sound cool, right, if you just wouldn't pay attention, because people say stuff right at you, and, then, you know, the ways they say it, it can make you think that it was cool. But what the part of drug testing and getting caught, we don't understand. You know what I'm saying? That's what getting caught means. That means, yeah, we had another test that you wasn't expecting, and that one caught you. Yeah, the test before and after, you know, you wasn't nothing in there. We didn't come, and we caught you in between. That's why we still caught some stuff in there, right? Because most of it gets out of your system in 3 or 4 days anyway. So you just got caught. That's what getting caught means. Oh, I had one before, and I was, you know, that was clean. I had one 2 days later, and I was clean. What happened in between? That's where the drugs popped off. I don't get the a drug test before and after stuff. Povetkin tried the same thing. Well, it's just trace amounts. That's what trace amounts mean. It's on the way out of your system. You got caught. That's what that means. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? I ain't no Big Bang Theory up in here, but man, we're talking about common sense. You know, everybody told me, hey, I was, you know, I had a test 2 weeks before and 2 weeks after, and I got caught here. What happened? That's what getting caught means. You know what I'm saying? As far as I'm concerned. So, at the end of the day, nobody wants Dylan White to be, you know, to be on drugs. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, if he didn't, then it would be cool too. You know what I'm saying? I like me a little Dylan White. I don't like the fact that he was in Britain right now because he was getting away with that. If he wasn't in Britain, he probably wouldn't be talking that kind of way about Deontay Wilder, like he wants to fight him, like no one understands you didn't fight Ortiz. You know what I mean? It gets away with that. It's the surroundings. It's called supply and demand. You know, I can say this here because people behind me like what I'm saying. You know, Trump type stuff. All right, but it doesn't mean it's right. You know, you got 15,000 opportunities to be mandatory for all kind of belts. And still hollering like somebody don't want to fight you. And then, you know, you're not beating anybody up bad. So no one's scared. You know what I'm saying? So that's that irks me, you know. But that has a lot with the Joshua syndrome, you know, because Joshua made everything a little bit bigger, you know. So everybody, you know, boxing became very high profile. And because of that, so, you know, Dillian White got the residue of that. And he's the second best, you know, over there, with, you know, depending on what you, where you put that Tyson Fury. But he's one of the top three for sure in Britain. So that means something, right? So speaking of which, that's two big hits. Joshua got beat up, looked like he's going to beat up again, and Dillian White drubbed. Unless he comes out, I mean, he's got a whole bunch of exoneration popping off here, right? But back to my bottom line before I even go in on Dillian that one, because whatever, man, you know, let's see what happens. But bottom line, it's 3 weeks out, and there's still no B sample. Now, I'm just saying, you know, people focus in, because I'm going to say it again. I know I repeat it, but when Deontay Wilder and Anthony Joshua were in negotiations to fight, they almost got it, you know, was about to get down, or either somebody's going to have to admit that they didn't want to fight. Then, you know, the WBA helped them by putting in Povetkin, saying that they had to sign a fight for Povetkin within 24 hours. That fight, just like this B-sample, took 3 weeks to sign after being mandated to have 24 hours. So just totally ignored you. Just bottom line, can we stop the Deontay Wilder negotiations because we have to fight Povetkin? First of all, who would do that and why? I think they were paid, being honest. Why would you want to get in front of a unification fight with a Povetkin? Get out of here without some kind of incentive, right? So that's bottom line what that is. And this Dillian White thing is taking way too long. It's looked like y'all were there finagling, figuring out what can we tell the public. That's what it sounds like. Prove us wrong. Doma Sports Talk. Worldwide. And I'm about to hear y'all.